Hello students, welcome to Saurav's classes. Let's discuss some problems regarding chemical thermodynamics. Among the following reaction that is accompanied by a decrease in the entropy is, among the reaction that is accompanied by a decrease in the entropy is, which one of this reaction will be accompanied by a decrease in the entropy? Nitrogen gas plus 3 hydrogen is equal to ammonia. C6H12O6. Look at these reactions, C6H12O6 plus 6O2, that is glucose, and then sucrose, and 6CO2, 6H2O, PCl5, PCl3, Cl2, 2H2O, H2, and oxygen. So the question marks is, among the following reaction that is accompanied by the decrease in entropy, which of the following will be accompanied by the decrease in entropy? So the answer is A. This reaction N2 gas plus 3H2 gas will be accompanied by a decrease in entropy. That will be accompanied by decrease in entropy. So now let's do, entropy is a measure of randomness, right? Why entropy, this one. Entropy is, what is entropy? Is the measure of randomness. Measure of is randomness. As a randomness, as a randomness disorder, that is disorder increases, entropy increases. Entropy increases. The order of entropy will be like this. The order of entropy solid, then it comes to liquid and is greater. So randomness is largest in the gas. Particles orderly arranged. In this solid, particles orderly arranged. Orderly arranged. And the gas most disordered. Most disordered are the gases. So the degree of randomness, that is entropy, will be the highest in the gases. Now thus, let's go ahead and do the reaction. So thus in reaction, reaction we have N2, which is gas, 3H2, again it's a gas, and we have 2NH3, again it's a gas. So entropy decreases because of number of gaseous molecules decreases. Now entropy in this particular case decreases because because number of gaseous molecules decreases. So that's why you, option A, that is, let's go ahead and find the option. N2 plus 3H2, the among the following reaction that is accompanied by decrease in entropy, and that is your reaction number A, N2 plus 3H2, which is followed by the decrease in entropy. Now let's go ahead to another question. The plot that describes a Carnot cycle. Which one of the plot describes a Carnot cycle? The plot that describes a Carnot cycle. A, this one, this one, this one, or this one. So it's A, probably. Yes, it's A. So in Carnot cycle, there are four processes. Two are reversible and two are adiabatic. In the given graph, graph A satisfied these processes. Two are reversible and two are adiabatic. So it's A that looks like this, right? This is your temperature, this is your entropy. And then why it is 2? Because in Carnot cycle, for Carnot cycle, in Carnot cycle, there are four processes. There are four processes. Two are reversible. Two are reversible and two are adiabatic. So in the given graphs, in the given graphs, in the given graphs, graph A satisfies these conditions, satisfies these. Let's have a look on this graph A again. These conditions: two are adiabatic, four processes, two are reversible and two are adiabatic. So if you can look, have a look on this, this graph is the best graph for the Carnot cycle, this one, okay? So two are adiabatic and two are reversible. The rate of evaporation of a liquid is always faster at a higher temperature because the enthalpy of evaporation is always endothermic. The rate of evaporation of a liquid is always faster at a higher temperature because the enthalpy of the vaporization always endothermic, the enthalpy of evaporation always exothermic. The enthalpy of evaporation is zero, the internal pressure of the liquid is less than that of the gas. The rate of evaporation of a liquid is always faster at a higher temperature. So why the rate of the evaporation of liquid is higher at, liquid is very higher at a higher temperature, is faster. The rate of evaporation is faster at a higher temperature. Why? Because the enthalpy of vaporization always exothermic. You know, it's an exothermic process. It's always, sorry, the enthalpy of vaporization, enthalpy is always endothermic. Sorry. It's the enthalpy of evaporation is always exothermic, endothermic, okay? The enthalpy is always endothermic. So, at the time what is the explanation of A? Your answer is this one. Let me do it, okay? The rate of evaporation of a liquid is always faster at a higher temperature because answer is the enthalpy of vaporization is always endothermic. Now, at the time of evaporation, energy is required to overcome the intermolecular forces between the molecules of liquid, between the molecules of liquid. That is, the enthalpy of evaporation is always endothermic. That is, the enthalpy of enthalpy that is the enthalpy of vaporization vaporization is always endothermic is always endothermic is always endothermic since at higher temperature more energy is available more energy is available so the rate of vibration is faster there. At elevated temperature. So therefore, the enthalpy of vibration is always endothermic. The rate of vibration is always faster at higher temperature because the enthalpy of vaporization is always endothermic. Thank you, students, for watching our video.